Hey guys, it's Jay from London and this is Chelsea Sense. So Lizzie from the video previous picked her favorites from the recommendations I gave her in the perfume hunting video. So now let's get scented. Delina. So Delina is one of the most popular female niche perfumes for women. It's one of the best sellers for this brand, Parfums de Marly. It has a very sexy, a soft floral scent, a rosy floral scent. So it has a strong feminine feeling with a non-transparent burst of florals. And the typical characteristic of this perfume, Delina, is its strong rhubarb scent. And as you know, some people really like the smell of rhubarb, but some don't. So the scent of rhubarb has a big love or hate to it. So the scent opens with a burst of juicy and sweet fruits, and in the middle notes, the presence of rosy peony and rhubarb is evident, and the durability is very good, and the reverberation is so beautiful. So the rose note in Delina is rich, velvety, and beautifully romantic, and it gives the fragrance a timeless and feminine quality. And complementing the rose are floral undertones of peony and lily of the valley, adding depth and complexity to the bouquet. It is characterized by a moderate sweetness and refinement that can be recommended to anyone. And I think this kind of sweetness is perfect for a gift. So I think anyone who receives Delina as a gift would be so happy. So what makes Delina stand out is its ability to balance traditional floral elements with a contemporary twist. And while the rose remains at the heart of the composition, the surrounding notes keep it fresh and modern, preventing it from feeling overly conventional or dated. So the longevity and sillage of the fragrance are generally well regarded, allowing it to last throughout the day and leave a lasting impression. Overall, Parfums de Marly perfumes, they have amazing longevity and performance. And I think it's a very pretty smell. So it's a very good fragrance. Next up is Byredo Rose of No Man's Land. I'm so sorry I couldn't bring that today, but the opening of Rose of No Man's Land by Byredo is a burst of pink pepper and Turkish rose petals. This initial combination delivers a bright and slightly spicy introduction, capturing your attention while hinting at the complexity to come. So it's very flirty. As the fragrance settles, the heart notes come forward, revealing the heart of the composition. The Turkish rose, absolute, and raspberry blossom beautifully intertwine and lending the scent a romantic and slightly fruity layer that prevents the rose from being overly traditional. So what truly sets this fragrance apart is its skillful transition into the base notes. So the papyrus and white amber base lends a gentle woodiness and warmth, adding depth and longevity to the overall experience. And this foundation is where the fragrance takes on its character, enhancing the rose's beauty while grounding it with a subtle earthiness. So Rose of No Man's Land is suitable for a wide range of occasions. It's versatile enough to be worn during both daytime and evening events. And I think for most seasons, it's very fitting. And even for cooler seasons, due to its slightly rich and warming nature, it will fit right in. And finally, it's Nishane's Wulong Cha. So, the name itself translates to dark dragon tea. It's referring to a type of oolong tea with a complex and deep flavor profile. So, the fragrance aims to evoke the aromas and sensations associated with this tea. It's blending together various notes to create a sensory experience. The scent opens with a burst of fresh and zesty citrus notes, which would mimic the feeling of steam rising from a cup of hot tea. And as it settles, you might detect the heart of the fragrance where the oolong tea note comes into play. So oolong tea is known for its intricate combination of floral, fruity, and slightly woody nuances. And in Wulong Cha, this note might be accompanied by hints of spices or herbs that are often found in traditional Chinese tea blends. So the base of the fragrance could include elements such as woods, musk, and perhaps a touch of sweetness from the fig, providing a foundation that lingers on the skin and gives the fragrance longevity. And now, so that was a quick review of the scents of the three fragrances from the video from before. So thanks so much for watching today. This was Jay from London, and this was Chelsea Scents. Thank you.
So what?